Hey everyone, in this Gauss elimination example video, we are asked to solve the following 2x2 matrix using Gauss elimination. Which means we need to solve for our two unknown variables, x and y, in the following system of linear equations. On the right here, I have placed the steps that we will follow in order to solve a system of equations using Gauss elimination. I recommend that you pause the video now and try to answer this question on your own first, and then validate your answer with mine. So, let's get right into the problem. Our first step says to create an augmented matrix, which separates our coefficient matrix and our constant matrix, or our scalar matrix, like so. Now, in order to solve this matrix, using Gauss elimination, we first need to transform this matrix into an upper triangular matrix, which means we need to turn all elements in our matrix below the diagonal to zero. Then, we use backward substitution to solve for the remaining variables. If we think about this, we actually have this question mostly solved. Remember that we are allowed to move our rows around within our augmented matrix, as this is not actually changing anything with our actual equations. Therefore, we can switch rows 1 and 2, and we get the following augmented matrix. As you can now see, our upper triangular matrix is actually now properly set up, as all the elements within our yellow triangle here are 0. So, let's begin using backward substitution to solve for our unknown variables, x and y. In our new equation 2, we have 2y equals 6. Therefore, y is equal to 3. Now, we can use this newly found y variable to solve for our unknown x variable, using equation 1. So, we have 7x plus 9 equals 2. Plugging in our y value, we have the following equation. Solving, we can see that x is equal to minus 25 over 7. Now, with Gauss elimination, we can actually go back and quickly validate our answers. Using our initial linear equations, we can just plug in our newly solved variables, and if the left and right hand side of our equation don't equal, then we know that we made a mistake somewhere. Firstly, we have 2 times 3 is equal to 6, which is true. Therefore, our variables are valid solutions to our first equation. Secondly, we have 7 times minus 25 over 7 plus 9 times 3 equals 2. This works out to minus 25 plus 27, which does equal 2. Therefore, our newly found variables are proper solutions to both of our initial equations. I hope that this Gauss elimination example video helped your understanding of the topic. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.